For this week, we're starting the installation of the new Staffordshire Hoard Gallery, which is the first permanent gallery for the Staffordshire Hoard at Birmingham Museum. So for the week, we're going to work with a mount maker called Richard West, who's come in specially to make purpose-made mounts so they all sit perfectly and are fully supported when they go on display. At the moment, Richard is making the mounts. He's made them the right size and shape for each object. He's also adding padding to make sure the objects aren't scratched or damaged while they're sitting on the mounts. The mounts are made from brass, which means they're very low in corrosion, which is very good. And also, he's coated them in plastic sleeves, which are shrink-wrapped onto the mount so that the object holds snugly and won't fall off. We're now in the Treasury. The Treasury has some of the more iconic objects from the Staffordshire Hoard to really showcase their brilliance. And one of the ways we're doing this is we're using these two turntables so that people can get a three-dimensional view of the objects. So in this case here, we're going to have two objects. One will be the mystery object. So for the first time, people will be able to see all the way around and underneath and possibly maybe make some more guesses about what the mystery object is. And also next to it, we'll have a great garnet pommel cap. And these garnets are some of the biggest within the board. Helping with the install this week is our new conservation intern, Rachel. She's from UCL and she'll be with the program for 10 months and she'll be working on the Staffordshire Hoard. The next object that we're going to install are the elements from the possible helmet that we have from the Staffordshire Hoard. So what Richard has done to help people understand the objects is he's created a perspex cutout of a head with a helmet on, and then we're going to overlay the cheek piece and the possible strip that we have over the top of those to give people an idea of what that helmet would have possibly looked like and where those objects would have sat upon it. So now all the objects are installed, we've just got a few more things to fix up and then we'll be ready for the opening date on the 17th of October.